I can't remember the last time I spoke about a car that almost no one has heard of. Now, of course, if you follow the motoring world, you will know what I'm speaking about. But the average person on the street probably wouldn't have a clue about what I'm about to show you. So ladies and gentlemen, here is the Ineos Grenadier.
The what now? This is the no-nonsense 4x4 vehicle that has been developed from the ground up on an all-new platform by the Ineos Group. You're probably wondering which manufacturer I'm talking about. Well, the Ineos Group is, in fact, a chemical company. It comprises of 36 businesses, with Ineos Automotive being one of the businesses, and the Grenadier is its only vehicle. You see, back in 2017, Jim Ratcliffe, who is a car enthusiast and experienced adventurer, identified a gap in the market for a stripped-back, utilitarian, hard-working 4x4, one that could be engineered for modern-day compliance and reliability. If we look at what is currently on the market that might fit this brief, you would look at something like the Toyota Land Cruiser or a G-Wagon, not the AMG version, obviously. Ratcliffe wanted it to be an alternative to the iconic Land Rover Defender, so much so that he initially tried to buy the rights and plans for the Defender, but Jaguar Land Rover was having none of that. So Ratcliffe forged ahead and combined rugged British spirit, Ineos's words, not mine, with German engineering rigor, and the Grenadier was born. We must mention, however, that Ineos partnered with BMW for the powertrain side of things. So the Grenadier will be powered by Beamer's petrol and diesel 3-litre straight-six engines.
We are currently here at the launch of this Grenadier in South Africa. Unfortunately, we don't get to test drive them ourselves, but we do get to sit shotgun in what is a prototype. And I can tell you, after having been in this car, it is exactly what it was meant to be, and that's hardcore. I'm sitting inside the Grenadier, but remember that this is a prototype, so it doesn't look how it's going to look. But I have seen pictures of it. And what I love is that it's not all touchscreen, touchscreen, touchscreen. In fact, it's all about simple ease of use. And so that means more buttons and more knobs.
It's all rather bulky in here, but it's meant to be. As much as it is in no way dripping in tech and modern touches, it certainly doesn't feel or look outdated. It has a more of an old school feel. One that I think many a previous generation Defender fan will appreciate. Not about the bells and whistles, it's about the capability. Just look at the roof. Can anyone say cockpit? I think my favorite part is the fact that the seats are water and dirt resistant. Can we not have these in every family car, please?
I wish I could tell you how it drives, but we'll just have to wait for that. But you can reserve your own Grenadier at this point, and it will be delivered in October. And pricing starts at just under 1.4 million rand.